Hi, it's John here. I want to talk about taking tomato cuttings. Now I've got a tomato here, it's called a yellow plum, and it took quite a while to grow from seed actually last year, and once it got going it was all right. We had a few tomatoes, but then it kept going through the winter, and I've taken the cuttings off it at various times. Now this one is the best little plant, I think, you know, the one that shows it off well. You know, it's quite compact, and it has some the trusses coming off very regular. You can let it bush up a bit because it doesn't go mad like a normal tomato. And these are the fruits here, and they remain yellow. They don't go red. Once they're on there, they don't take long to ripen. So this is another plant. I'm not sure whether this is a cutting or one that I took, or one original seeds, but it's still got a lot of life in it. But as you can see, it gets a bit straggly over the period of time. I mean, there's tomatoes coming right at the top there, so it's still quite vigorous. It hasn't given up as some plants do. Now to take the cutting, I just find a bit that's sort of in the wrong place, as it were, and just snip it off like that, and perhaps just take that leaf off there. I'll actually take that one off as well whilst I'm cutting. And then the way I've worked it, just get a little bit of water in the bottom of a glass or a jar, and just put it in there. So it's just resting on the bottom, and after about a week or 10 days is what I prepared earlier. After about a week or 10 days, lo and behold, if the camera comes in slightly, see little white roots, and sometimes there's masses of roots come off, and it's still got quite a lot of life in it. You see, it's got little things coming off here, which I'll let go. So that's ready for potting up again now, and this is one that I potted up about a week ago. You know, I had these little white roots on, then potted up in potting compost, and it looks a very healthy plant, lovely little plant. So I've been lucky enough to keep this going all winter. It's spring at the moment, and of course, if you are able to take cuttings from your tomatoes and keep them going all winter, you get them cropping much earlier, and that well, I mean, it's always the earliest crop which is the best. They do even have tomatoes through the winter, but when they don't have any sun, I think they get a little bit, you know, they're not very sweet. I'm going to eat one in a minute. And there's no bees around, so I always take the tissue more or less every day when I say hello to them, and just spread the pollen around a bit so as to help them to fertilise. But I think actually these ones, they don't take much fertilisation anyway. They seem to pollinate themselves more or less. Right, I'm going to eat one now just to see what the flavour's like. If I remember rightly, oh, it's just come off. That probably means it's ripe. If I remember rightly, they have a slightly citrusy sort of flavour. That was nice. Real typical tomato flavour. Excellent. Just like I remember getting tomatoes at my grandpa's greenhouse a number of years ago. Right. Bye for now.